On the occasion of the celebration of 75 years of WFTU, this is Swadesh Dev Roy, Deputy General Secretary WFTU, New Delhi. The most significant world socio-economic features preceding to the foundation of WFTU in the year 1945 were A. The Great Depression of the capitalist market of the 1930s, B. Defeat of the fascist forces led by the Soviet Union, C. Emergence of the powerful bloc of socialist states. In course of its proud and eventful journey through the path of class struggle for the last 75 years, the WFTU has remained committed to its lofty ideals and carrying out the organizational task strictly within the framework of working class democracy. The basic features are open, transparent, democratic, and class oriented. As a champion of class struggle, WFTU has forthrightly propagating, fighting against the doctrine of imperialist globalization and neoliberalism, and has been vocal against the class collaborationist. WFTU fought Truman Marshall Doctrine immediately after its birth, and in the present context, Reagan and Becker plan of neoliberalism. One of the significant achievements of WFTU since its foundation has been the champion and solidarity action in support of the national liberation movements, particularly in the continents of Africa, Asia, and Latin America, and still continues to prioritize the cause of the people of developing countries who are under the hegemonic ploy of imperialist forces. WFTU pioneered the understanding of the present capitalist crisis as the systemic crisis of capitalism. Organization and movement committed to class struggle only can provide scientific leadership to the toiling people. This is the cream of the achievement of WFTU during its long journey of 75 years. Even in the present COVID-19 pandemic world situation, the collective understanding of the Secretariat of WFTU has been excellently captured by Comrade George Mavrikos, the General Secretary of WFTU, in his article titled "The King is Naked." The article has been written with the spirit of conviction, courage, and ideological richness. The message is, from socio-economic crisis to natural calamities, the movement committed to overthrow capitalism and establish socialism must articulate all developments in the class perspective, and the past, the present, and the future of WFTU must continue to pursue this path of class orientation, and the edge of the movement must be anti-imperialism, anti-monopoly, with ultimate goal of class exploitation-free people's world. Long live WFTU, long live class struggle.